Growing up on the Jersey Shore, Krista Isom was used to the summer sun.
I would wear usually the light sunscreen. You know, you go to the beach, you want to get color, and you just never think that anything is going to happen.
But a few years ago, she noticed something unusual.
I saw a red bump on the top of my foot, so I made an appointment with a dermatologist. I kind of just had it removed just because it was kind of ugly and I didn't want it there, but I didn't think anything of it.
A biopsy revealed Krista had melanoma, and a year-long battle began.
I just basically was in shock. I didn't really know how serious it would be. I thought that they would just have to, scrape a little bit off my foot. I actually had to have a skin graft taken from my leg, and my foot was very swollen for about 6 months.
But her journey was just beginning. Additional tests revealed Krista's melanoma had spread to her lymph nodes.
Younger patients tend to have higher number of lymph node metastasis than older patients. Now, why is that? Well, we think that the lymphatic system is perhaps more robust in our younger patients rather than in some of our older patients where it's atrophied over time. As a young woman, her risk of actually having a lymph node metastasis once she had this intermediate thickness melanoma was actually fairly significant.
Doctors at Northwestern performed a new surgery to remove Krista's cancer.
So instead of making a large, maybe 1 foot incision or 8 inch incision to remove all those lymph nodes in the groin region, we're able to make 3 small half inch incisions to use a laparoscopic camera and remove those lymph nodes endoscopically.
I was really lucky in that sense where my recovery time was still long and I was still very swollen, but it wasn't as bad as it could have been.
Krista underwent 5 months of chemotherapy and is now cancer-free, but says the experience taught her a valuable life lesson.
In all honesty, your health is more important than the way you look, and it's hard to tell people that because people try to tell me that, but when nothing's ever happened to you like that, you don't really care. I'm a lot different now when it comes to my health. Now I just realize, I guess, that your health is the most important thing that you have, and you can't really take it for granted.
Dr. Wayne says it's important for everyone to keep a close eye on their skin, but especially those with risk factors.
Not every patient fits into the perfect profile of risk factors, but certainly family history is something we ask about. Certainly, again, high dose episodic sun exposure as a child, frequent blistering sunburns, we want to hear about that. Other risk factors, obviously light complexion, fair skin type, are at increased risk for melanomas. If we can diagnose these things early and get people, treated with small operations, that makes a lot more sense.